Mighty Sweet Therefore shall we render unto the Lord for all his mercies, for all his goodness, for all his favor towards us. As people of God, we will always praise him, we will always exalt him, we will always magnify his name. For he's been so good, he's been so kind to us over the years, and we give the Lord all the praise and glory and honor due his name. Thank you, Spirit of God, for the multitude of your mercies over fire citizens all over the world. Be glorified and be exalted forever. Hallelujah. A blessed day to your family and guests worshiping with us all over the world. On behalf of our Father and lead pastor, His Eminence Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman, I welcome you all to Fire City Chapel, the home of Word Fire Generation Ministries, the headquarters of heaven. This is the very place where God is, and we want to thank God and praise God for the life of our Father Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman, who has curated this haven for us to always have access to the voice of God, to the word of God, so that we can always have the knowledge of what to do to advance in life, to be relevant in the agenda of God, and to be in the will of God at all times. We pray for more strength for our Father. We pray that the grace of God will multiply, and we pray that the strength of God will always be his portion. And we are praying that God will open many doors for our Father in Jesus' mighty name. Family and guests, can you say, arrange it, Lord? So thank you so much for deciding to be part of today's Destiny service. This is the pre-service discussion segment of our service, and I know that it's going to be a blessing to you. Thank you for choosing to be part of us tonight, and we want to encourage you to share our link with your friends, colleagues, family members on Facebook, on YouTube, so that they can be part of the service. I know that God has a lot to better our lot. Somebody's life can be turned around through this discussion, through tonight's service. Ensure that the person will not miss out on what God has prepared for us, and the person's life will never be the same. God richly bless you one more time for deciding to be part of today's service. We are in a year of open doors. 2024 is a year of open doors, and by the grace of God, we are enjoying open doors in this house. And we pray that everywhere you are worshiping with us, from the same will be your story, that whatever door that God has prepared for you, you'll be empowered, you'll be strengthened, you will be helped by the Spirit of God to be able to walk through every open door. Can you say open doors?
Open doors.
Come on, shout it, open doors.
Open doors.
One more time, shout it, open doors.
Open doors.
Woman of God, this is something that we have been enjoying
as
Fire Citizens. And we pray that anyone worshiping with us as a guest, as an associate all over the world, you'll be part of this blessing. And we have declared several open doors. We have named many doors that are opening unto us. But recently the bishop helped us by the voice of the Spirit to understand that there are certain doors, if you are not introduced to by the Spirit of God, you will never notice them.
Yeah, exactly.
He calls them the not obvious doors. And from the past week, we have been discussing some of these doors. I remember we talked about the door of submission. We have also talked about the door of loyalty. Today we want to look at the door of humility. The door of humility. And I know that is really going to be a blessing to you, the door of humility. A lot of the times we project and pronounce doors of greatness, doors of prosperity, doors of wisdom, doors of creativity, and they are very important doors, and we need them. But a lot of the times this particular door, and the doors we have discussed already, doors of submission and the doors of loyalty, we rarely consider them.
Sometimes
it doesn't even come to mind.
It doesn't come to mind.
Because you don't think about it.
Yes.
But you see, these are the doors that carries the ability to establish the doors of greatness that are open to us, the doors of prosperity. Because you can receive the prosperity. You can enter into heights of greatness. And for some reasons, you can come down if you have not experienced the door of humility. Because humility in our work with God is key. It is so key. Because God can expose you to heights of revelations, heights of wealth. And if you are not careful, you will have no regard for any man. But the more you get to know God, the more you walk with God, the more you will learn to humble yourself. So, woman of God, I know it's important we discuss this door of humility.
It's very important, man of God. For me, I've always been saying that those of us here at Fire City Chapel will forever bless God for the life of Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi
Hackman. Exactly.
Because looking at this not obvious doors, if he had not mentioned them, we would have gone through the entire year.
Doors of greatness.
I'm telling you.
Doors of prosperity.
We receive it all. And yet we wouldn't know the demands that are on our lives. Yeah. So that if we fulfill them, then these doors of prosperity and these doors of greatness would open up to us. We have come to understand over the years that when God gives you a blessing, there is always a demand attached to it. And so if you don't get to know the demands to work so that the blessings will come into manifestation, you will go through the entire season and you think that God doesn't love you. You will go through the entire season and you see others enjoy the blessings for the season and yet you are not enjoying them. And that is because you have not noticed the demands that are attached to the blessings. And so it is very important. And forever we will bless God for Bishop's life
because
like these kind of things, we never know them. But when we have these meetings with him, when he meets with us and then he teaches us, he brings into our space these things that we must know so that we must work them. So man of God, talking about the doors of humility, it is very important because one of the things that brings great people down has to do with pride. Like sometimes God has not even lifted you to that very point where you are supposed to be. You are on the journey and you think you know it all, you think you have it all.
Small exposure,
I'm telling
small
you,
significance that comes into
I'm
your
telling
life
you.
That you think
yes
you
are the boss, you have arrived, and you treat people
boss
anyhow, exactly, commanding people anyhow. But when for this generation, we are so blessed because everything that God will teach us, we have that example,
a living example.
I'm telling you, we have somebody to look at to say that what God is saying is very true. Man of God, the kind of humility that our Father expresses.
Incredible.
Thinking about his level of greatness, like I don't.
I'm
telling you. And yet he's so humble. He speaks to people in power with all humility. And when it comes to even little children, my goodness, the kind of respect the bishop
the other
gives
day,
to
I
them.
I noticed the bishop sitting on the floor with the kids.
My goodness.
Some nice time.
How many great people out there will do this? They will tell you that they are not for these ones. They will tell you that they are weightier matters that they are supposed to talk about. They are passing and they won't even look at you to wave at you. But the bishop would always have time standing with you. Immediately he sees you and maybe he notices that your countenance is not good. He comes close to you asking you, are you okay? Is there any problem? And whatever it is that you share with him, he will go all out to sort it out for you. We pray for the people that belong to God all over the world, that as the Spirit of God has... Pray that the Spirit of God from today would open the doors of humility for us, and may he hold our hands to lead us through these doors, that would he only know that they are not obvious doors like the doors of humility and not do anything about it, but as we have come to know about it, may the Spirit of God empower us that now we would have the ability to be humble, that anything that will cause us to be proud, the Spirit of God will take it out of our way. But every morning, every afternoon, every evening, he shall humble our hearts before him so that the greater blessings that he has for us, he would release it upon us. Can you say, show me your glory?
Show me your glory. So, woman, before we proceed, there's this incredible and amazing scripture in the book of Philippians chapter 2 from verse 5. And for the time left to us, I think when I read it, it will be good enough.
Yeah.
It was
like it summarizes everything when it comes to
talking
humility.
About Jesus himself and how he exemplified humility and the benefits it came with, such that when God lifted him high, God was proud and was comfortable knowing that no matter the heights of glory is lifted to, this man will be able to maintain it.
Exactly.
And he's our greatest example. So family, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I'm reading Philippians chapter 2 from verse 5 in the Amplified version. It says that, let this same attitude and purpose and humble mind be in you which was in Christ Jesus. Let him be your example in humility. Who, although being essentially one with God and in the form of God, possessing the fullness of the attributes which make God God, did not think this equality with God was a thing to be eagerly grasped or retained. Verse 7 says, but stripped himself of all privileges and rightful dignity, so as to assume the guise of a servant, a slave, in that he became like men and was born a human being. The God of very God allowed himself to be born a human being. Verse 8 says that, and after he had appeared in human form, he abased and humbled himself still further, and carried his obedience to the extreme of death, even the death of the cross. Verse 9 says, therefore, because he stooped so low, God has highly exalted him and has freely bestowed on him the name that is above every name. Verse 10, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. Amazing. This is an incredible scripture that summarizes everything about humility.
Yeah.
And as the Spirit of God reminds us and exposes us to the doors of humility, I pray that we will have the strength to walk in humility, such that God will feel free to lift us higher, knowing very well that we have demonstrated humility, so that there's no heights of glory you will lift us to that you'll be scared that we'll miss it or we'll lose it and, you know, forget about things and lose their blessings. One of God, the scripture is just incredible.
Yeah, it's very simple. Like, it is understandable. You can't say that you don't understand this one, seriously.
But I know there are a few things we can touch
of course,
to bless the
of
people
course,
of God
of course.
For some time. Jesus, God of very God, first of all, was okay to allow himself to be stripped of his divinity, his Godship, so that he can be born as a man. This is a height of humility you can't think about.
Exactly.
That in spite of the glory that he has, he carried. I remember he was praying and he was telling the Father that he should give him the glory that he had with him before the foundations. He was ready to set it aside and come to be born on earth as a human being.
Yeah.
To suffer what men suffers,
men suffer.
What a humility!
It's amazing.
Because I can hardly see people that have been privileged to possibly occupy some governmental position as an MP, as a governor, as a CEO of a global conglomerate, and of themselves they want to step down.
Yeah,
some people have run for parliamentary seat for years, and for some reasons they don't want to, you know, vacate
the place for someone.
Some people have become presidents, and for some reasons they will want to amend constitutions so that they will never leave the presidency, whatever means they will use, because they cannot leave power.
Yeah,
they cannot see power and decide to come down and allow other people to occupy, especially when they have tasted the joy, the beauty, the glories of it.
Exactly.
They would never want to humble themselves. Yeah. But we are talking about Jesus. God
he had
flesh,
it all. My
who
goodness.
Who had it all.
My goodness.
Earth,
yeah.
And was ready to put aside everything to come and face the hardship of humanity and pay every price necessary that man has to pay so that he can free man. And it was not bothered about the shame and the disgrace
exactly.
it had to go through.
To that point.
To that point.
My goodness.
Family, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I pray that we have that humility, that spirit.
We receive
not
it.
To fight, to be there and fight everybody and want to bust things over everybody. But you see, if you have the quality and you know who you are, it's easy to humble yourself.
Exactly.
I pray that we'll have that understanding, that revelation.
Amen.
That will help us to humble ourselves. Because when you do this humility thing, in other words, when you are able to pass through this door of humility, God will lift you to heights that you can never imagine.
Amazing. You know, with this example of Jesus Christ, it's like, man, we don't have an excuse to say that we can't be humble.
At all, at all.
You can't say that it is by nature to be proud.
I'm
like that. This is how I am. As far as for me, like, take me however I am.
You are not born like that.
I'm
telling you. You have decided to be like that.
To be like that. And so if the very God of very God could come on earth
my goodness,
and experience humanity and humble himself, it means that we don't have any excuse as to why we can't be humble, especially the people of God. Because like, he's the very God of very God. I was going to say that he's of God, but he is the very God of very God. I remember one of the days when our father touched on the humility side of Jesus. He said that at that point in time when the Sanhedrin and the Pharisees and all those people were, he could have just said, he could have just slaughtered them with one word, just speaking one word. Like, he had so much power.
So much power.
And yet, he didn't abuse anybody, even his enemies, his own enemies. He was so humble that he didn't touch them because he understood the reason why he was born.
Yeah.
If in any case he exhibited pride or did something outside the instructions of his father, he would have messed up the whole salvation plan for man. So somebody who has such power and could humble himself. Family, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we don't have any excuse. It is possible to be humble. I remember our father praying for us that if we don't even want to go through those doors that God will open up to us, God will drag us through it. We see the Spirit of God hold your hands and drag you through the doors of humility. Can you say open doors? From today, may you have the ability of divinity to be humble so that the greater blessings that God has for you, he would release it upon you in the name of Jesus. Can you say amen?
Amen.
There's our time would allow us. We are joining in the main service and we pray that the Spirit of God would breathe upon you
the
Spirit of humility, that as we go through tonight's service, one of the blessings that you would carry home will be the blessing of humility.
Amen.
That the Spirit of God will speak into your spirit, he will speak into your heart and help you greatly so that you will be named as one of the people that were that was humble in his generation and the Spirit of God lifted you up so high. So thank you so much, family and distinguished guests, for joining us for today's Destiny service. Thank you for coming and God richly bless you. Amen.
Amen. said, if you are a fire citizen, I pray that God will not allow you to hide. When your doors open, I said, when your doors open, and you said, open doors. When your doors open, you will move through it. I said, when your doors open, you will move through it. Your doors of prosperity, when they open, you will move through it. Your doors of healing, when they open, you will move through it. I said, your doors of upliftment, when they open, you will move through it. Do you believe it? Do you receive it? Lift your hands and say, show me your glory.
Family, it's now time for praise and worship. God bless you.
Hallelujah!
Yeah.
To him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we could ask or think, be glory, honor, and power forever and ever.
Yeah. Yeah. shall begin to bless the name of the Lord. For he is good, and his mercies endureth forever. Almighty God, what shall we render to you for your faithfulness, for your goodness towards Fire City Chapel? We are here to say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Spirit of the living God. You have done more than enough for us. And we are here to bless your holy name. We are here to bless your holy name. We are here to bless your holy name. We are here to say thank you, Spirit of God, for being a faithful God. We say thank you. For being an awesome God, we say thank you. King of glory, take all the glory. King of glory, take all the glory. You are the King of kings. You are the Lord of lords. There is no one like you, Lord. There is no one like you, Almighty God. That is why we choose to praise you. That is why we choose to exalt you. You are holy and there is none like you. Take all the glory. 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 For you alone are worthy, Spirit of God. Awesome God, we praise you. Mighty God, we exalt you. We say you are worthy to be praised. There is no other reason why we came today than to exalt your holy name. Your name is greatly to be praised. We are here to exalt you, King of glory. Covenant keeper, we say thank you. Promise keeper, we say thank you. Awesome God, we say thank you. We bless your name, oh God. We bless your name, oh God. We bless your name, oh God. Let the people praise thee. Let the people praise thee. Let the people praise thee. The Lord God Almighty. The Lord strong and mighty. We bless you, Almighty God. the Lord, the faithful God of fire city chapel.
Praise the name of the Spirit of the Living God. Praise the Lord, Fire City Chapel. Let the earth hear His voice. Praise the Spirit of the Living God. Let His people rejoice. Bless the name of the Spirit of the Living God. Give Him all the glory and give Him all the honor. Bless His holy name in the mighty name of Jesus. Praise the Lord, Fire City Chapel. Praise the Lord, Fire City Chapel. Let the earth hear His voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let His people rejoice. Magnify the name of the Lord. Bless His holy name in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever you are, lift up your voice and give God all the praise that is due His name. Let us bless the name of the Spirit of the Living God in the name of Jesus. The psalmist says that I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. Fire City Temple, fire citizens all over the world, let us magnify the Lord together. Let us exalt His holy name together. Wherever you are, lift up your voice. Begin to praise the name of the living God. Begin to bless the name of the living God. Give Him all the glory that is due His name. In the mighty name of Jesus,
We give you
lift
glory,
up your voice and bless the name of the Spirit of the Living God. We magnify you, Spirit of the Living God. We bless your holy name, Abba Father. We exalt you, King of Glory. For there is none, O God, like unto you. In the mighty name of Jesus, O God, we give you the glory. We give you the glory. You are, O God, an awesome God. You are magnificent. You are, O God, the King of Glory. We magnify you in the name of Jesus. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, the name of the Lord is to be praised. We praise you and we bow before you. We praise you and we exalt your holy name. We praise you and we sing glory unto you. In the mighty name of Jesus. For there is none like unto you, O God. There is none like unto you, O God. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. We bless your holy name. We exalt your name together. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallowed be unto your name. You alone are great. You alone are awesome. You alone are mighty. You alone are worthy. We bow before you, O God. And we lift your name on higher. In the name of Jesus. Spirit of the living God. We give you the praise that is to your name. We give you the praise that is to your name. We give you the glory that is to your name. In the mighty name of Jesus, we bow before you, O God, and we magnify you. In the name of Jesus, O God, receive all the praise, O God. Receive all the praise, O God. Receive all the praise, O God. Receive all your glory, O God. Receive all your honor, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallowed be unto your name. Honor be unto your name. Glory be unto your name. In the mighty name of Jesus, Spirit of the living God, we give you the glory. We give you the praise. And we honor you in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Abba.
Family, I want us to pray for the lead pastor of our city chapel, Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman. We are thanking the Spirit of the living God for his life. We are thanking God for preserving his life. We are thanking God for protecting him. We are thanking God for being his shield. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That God has been his high tower. He has been his horn of salvation. And we are praying tonight, we are asking that God will provide everything that he would ever need in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That he will have everything in abundance in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
2 Corinthians chapter 8, chapter 9, the verse number 8 in the New Living Translation, the Bible said that, and God will generously provide all you need. Then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are praying that the Spirit of the living God will provide him with everything that he will ever need on this journey in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That he will always have everything in the name of Jesus. Then you have plenty left over to share with others in the mighty name of Jesus. We are praying that the heavens above him will be open towards him.
Amen.
And God will rain prosperity.
Amen.
God will rain wealth.
Amen.
God will rain strength.
Amen.
God will rain peace.
Amen.
God will rain joy.
Yes,
upon his life. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lift up your voice and begin to pray.
We
Spirit of the living God,
God,
we give you the glory and we give you the honor. We magnify you in the name of Jesus. We are so much grateful to you, O God, for all things, O God. For the things, O God, that you keep doing for us, O God. We give you the praise and we give you the glory. Thank you, O God. Thank you, O God, for the pastor. We thank you, O God, for protecting him. We thank you, O God, for shielding him. We thank you, O God, for being, O God, his strength, O God, in the name of Jesus. Strength, O God, like no other. We bless your holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus, O God, you are being the lifter of his head. Spirit of the living God, we commit him, O God, into your mighty hands, O God. Let your wealth, O God, come into his life. Let your strength, O God, be released upon his life. Let your joy and your peace, O God, be released, O God, upon him. Let your serenity, O God, come, O God, in the name of Jesus. Bless him, O God, in all things, O God. May you provide, O God, unto him, O God,
everything that he will need in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, that he will never lack any good thing in the name of Jesus, King of glory. We pray, oh God, that you would empower him, oh God, that he would abound unto every good work in the name of Jesus. Let your grace, oh God, be made sufficient for him, oh God, in all things, oh God, that you have all things, oh God, in abundance in the name of Jesus, oh God. Let your blessing keep coming into his life in the name of Jesus. Let your blessing keep flowing in his life, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Spirit of the living God, we ask that you do something that will change everything in his life in the mighty name of Jesus. Almighty God, King of glory, Lord Almighty, may you be with him, oh God, and be gracious, oh God, unto him, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We give God the praise
in the name of Jesus,
and we give God the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Family, I want us to pray for fire citizens all over the world. We are blessing the Spirit of the living God for each and every one of us. We are thanking him for always ordering our steps aright in the name of Jesus. And we are asking that God will help each and everyone to understand the times and the seasons and the ability to know what to do in the name of Jesus. The Bible said in the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 12, the verse number 32, the Bible said that, and of Issachar, men who had understanding of the times to know what Israel ought to do. We are praying that God will give us understanding in all things in the mighty name of Jesus. And we are praying for the ability to know what to do in every season the Spirit of the living God would usher us into in the mighty name of Jesus. We are praying that the great teacher, he will teach us his ways. He will lead us in his truth. He will lead us in his path in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. We bless your name, Spirit of the living God. We give you the glory and we give you the honor in the mighty name of Jesus. We bow before you and we give you the glory. We bow before you and we give you the honor. Spirit of the living God, you have been so good and so kind, oh God, to the Fire City family. You have been, oh God, with the fire citizens, oh God. We thank you, oh God, and we bless you for always keeping an eye, oh God, over us, oh God. Thank you, oh God, for your eye, oh God, that is going, oh God, to and fro, oh God, looking for, oh God, your royal people, oh God, to release that blessing upon their lives. We thank you, oh God, that you set, God, and you found, oh God, fire citizens. We pray in the name of Jesus, oh God, that you be with us, oh God. Help us, oh God, to understand the times. Help us, oh God, to understand the seasons, oh God. Help us to know what we ought to do as a generation in the name of Jesus. Spirit of the living God, may you help us, oh God. Spirit of the living God, every time that you usher us is good, every season, oh God, that the Spirit of truth, oh God, will lead us, oh God, into. We pray for the ability to understand and to know what to do in the name of Jesus, oh God. We pray for the eyes, oh God, to see, the ears to hear, the heart to perceive in the name of Jesus, the hearing ear, the seeing eyes. Spirit of the living God, you made them both. So we pray in the name of Jesus that you help us, oh God, to hear when you talk. We will see, oh God, when you move in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your glory be established in our lives, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let your glory be upon every fire citizen in the name of Jesus. The ability to know what to do, the ability, oh God, to be lifted above the elements of nature in the name of Jesus. We give you the praise. And we give you the glory.
And we praise your holy name.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, our Father.
Everlasting Father, eternal King, we glorify your holy name in the mighty name of Jesus. There is none like unto you, Spirit of the living God. We bow before you tonight and we sing glory and praises unto your most holy name in the mighty name of Jesus. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name is to be praised. Therefore, we praise your most holy name, Spirit of the living God. Take all your glory tonight. Take all your praise tonight. Be thou honored tonight. Be thou exalted tonight. We glorify you tonight and we bless you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Now you shall praise the Lord. Bless the name of the Spirit of the living God.
Give him all the honor that is due his name. Glorify the King of Glory. He is worthy of all our praise. He is worthy of all our honor. He is worthy of everything that we give to him tonight. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Family, it is time to take our congregational prayer. The prayer is on our screen. So shall we pray. But truly, I am full of power by the Spirit of the Lord and of judgment and of might to accomplish all that I cannot accomplish. So help me God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Family, I want us to acknowledge the lead pastor of our city chapel, Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman. Bishop, as a family, we are so much grateful to you. We thank you for always bringing to us the mind of God concerning our times, concerning this season. We bless the Spirit of the Living God for your life. And we want to be grateful to you for Destiny Camp, Destiny Boot Camp. Reloaded. God richly bless you, Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman. Fire City Chapel, Fire Citizens all over the world, we love you and we say God bless you. Amen. Family, you may please have your seat.
Fire City Chapel, Fire City, we go pay your money. Pay. We can also move the money. We can Baba Homely. Amen.
I am Heart of Divinity. I am Father's Perfect Will. I am the Fidelity of Divinity. I am Father's Gift. We prosper and we live forever. We will enjoy this year and everything will be all correct, sir. This year, everything that God has said concerning us, every promise that God has given us this year, it will be possible and it will happen double. Arrange it, Lord.
Amen.
A blessed evening to you, all distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. This is Fire City Chapel, home of Word Fire Generation Ministries. This is the headquarters of heaven. This is the very place where God is. On behalf of the bishop, I welcome you all to tonight's destiny service. I welcome you to the glory of God. I welcome you to the atmosphere of heaven. Tonight I see the Spirit of the Living God open many doors for us.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I see God do something that will change everything in our lives. I see God do something in our minds that will change everything in our lives. I see the Spirit of the Living God do something in our families that will change everything in our families. Can you say, show me your glory?
Amen.
It is time to take a song ministration from the music ministry. It is our prayer that as they minister to us through song, the Spirit of the Living God will service every destiny that is gathered before him tonight in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be blessed by tonight's service and God richly bless you. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
He is a great God. Jehovah is your name. What is it that is too hard for you to do? We praise your holy name, Jehovah. Because you are worthy. You are worthy. Yeah. Jehovah.
Jehovah is your name. You are the mighty warrior.
God, we bless your holy name. We worship you in the name of Jesus. We acknowledge that there is none like you. You are the mighty warrior. You are mighty in battle. Jehovah is your name. People of God, there was a time in the life of the children of Judah, the children of Israel. The Bible said that they were confronted with an enemy position, and they were confronted with a situation that was beyond them. And they told the Most High God, the army and the thing that is ahead of us, it is greater than us. We don't know what to do. We have no strength of our own. When we look at what is ahead of us and where we are, we don't have any strength of our own. And they called on the Most High God. They fasted and they prayed. And they called on the Most High God. And the Most High God came back to them and he told them that this battle is not yours. This battle is mine. And the Most High God went into battle and fought for the children of Israel, that the children of Israel did not lift a finger, but God went ahead of them and did only what he can do. Tonight we are acknowledging the mighty warrior. We are acknowledging the God who is great in battle. May every battle in your life be dealt with by the Most High God in the name of Jesus. Every battle with sickness, every battle with confusion, every battle with your finances, any battle you are experiencing as a family, tonight we call on the mighty warrior. We know he can do a better job. It is our destiny service. We don't have any might of our own. It is a new season for the Fast City family, and we call on the mighty warrior in the mighty name of Jesus. That anything that rises up against the people of God, anything that rises up against his own, he will deal with it by the power of his spirit. And that it will not be by might, it will not be by power, but it will be by the spirit of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, can you shout praise the Lord? Can you shout praise the Lord? Can you shout praise the Lord? We praise the mighty warrior. We praise the mighty warrior. And we give him all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Family, please join me as I acknowledge the presence of greatness in our midst tonight. In the person of our lead pastor, our dearest father, the commander-in-chief of Destiny Boot Camp Reloaded. He is the king observer of life. An accurate interpreter of life, and we give praise and thanks to God for the life of our Father. Bishop, we acknowledge your presence and we thank you for the amazing leader that you are. We thank you for these few weeks of encounter and experiences with you, and our lives have not been the same. We have been born again and born again and born again. We are resurrected believers, right? And we thank God for your life. We are grateful. Are there resurrected believers in the house? You know, 2 weeks ago, I knew I was a resurrected believer. But just this weekend, I knew again that I'm a resurrected believer because of the encounter we had with a man who is full of the Spirit of God, a man that is full of faith, a man that is full of the Word of God. Bishop, God richly bless you and open many doors for you. Amen. Family, before you sit down, can you turn to your neighbor and prophesy to your neighbor that open doors? Can you turn to another neighbor and tell that neighbor that open doors? Hallelujah. I think you can even go ahead and tell the person that a happy new year to you. And it is a new year of many open doors. Open doors. If you are online and you are alone, you can put your hands together and declare open doors. Many open doors.
Hallelujah. Amen. Family, can please take our seats in His glory. I am treasures of wisdom. I prosper and I live forever. We will enjoy this year and everything will be all correct, sir. I see God bless the Fire City family and open many doors for us. Can you declare open doors? On behalf of our dearest lead pastor and father, His Eminence Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman, I welcome each and every one of you to our Destiny service. We welcome all our first-time guests, our recurring guests, everybody joining us online, first-time guests, recurring guests, family. Thank you so much for being part of today's Destiny service. We have been praying and fasting all day, and tonight you are going to pray and fast. You are going to pray, I should say. And I believe that the heavens should be open, or the heavens are open over us. We are still appealing to the Spirit of God. We are still petitioning the heavens, and we are desiring mercies from the Spirit of God. Here at Fire City Chapel, we believe that after the resurrection of Christ, something new has begun with us. We believe that we are in a new season. We are in a new dispensation. We are operating in the next level with God. This is a path we have never walked on before. This is a dimension we have never walked before. This is a phase in our journey with God we have never walked on before. So we are humble enough to desire mercies from Him and ask Him to lead us by His Spirit. Ask Him to guide us by His Spirit. To ask Him to help us by His Spirit so that we can do well. Because something new has begun for us. Something incredible has begun for us. And we know that God is going to empower us to walk through many open doors in the mighty name of Jesus. And that quick thing God wants to do, He will not pass us by. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are desiring mercies from the Spirit of God. We are telling Him that we know that He's doing something in the air and that He will not pass the Fire City family by. In the mighty name of Jesus, so that when we see that men are cast down, for us, we will see that there is a lifting up. In the name of Jesus, so that when doors are closed to others, for the Fire City family and the chosen ones of God, we know that it is many open doors. Tonight, we are going to desire mercies from God, and we are going to enter into a time of prayer tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, I'd like you to rise to your feet wherever you are as we continue in this moment of prayer, as we continue in this atmosphere of prayer. I want us to have in mind that it is a new season the Spirit of God has ushered us in. It is a new atmosphere He has ushered us in. We need His guidance. We need His direction. We need His help. But before we pray for the Fire City family, we like to pray for the father of this house, the one through whom we get to know the ways of God, the one through whom we get to know the mind of God. And we are also going to desire mercies from the Spirit of God, that in this new season, the Spirit of God will continue to show Himself strong in the life of our Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Psalm 115, the verse number 14. The Bible says that the Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your children. The Lord shall increase you more and more, you and your family, you and your children. We are praying to the Spirit of God, thanking God for the life of our Father. It is a new season for us. It is a new dispensation. It is a new environment altogether for us. And we are asking the Spirit of God at whatever level of increase our Father walked in previous year, in this new season, the Spirit of God should empower our Father to increase more and more. That many open doors, that the blessings of the Lord will be replete. And not only to our Father, but to His children, to His family, and all that concerns Him, that when He turns to the left, the right, the north, the south, the east, and west, He will only see increase in the name of Jesus, and it should be multiplied. Increase should be replete in the mighty name of Jesus, in wisdom, in creativity, and in every aspect of our Father's life, in the mighty name of Jesus. Family, let's lift up our voices and pray to the Most High God for our Father. Our Father, we give a praise in the name of Jesus. Thank you that this is the day you have made. We will be glad and rejoice in it. Thank you that this is the season that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for ushering us into this new season. We bless your name for opening up this new season, this new year, this new atmosphere for this family and wealth, for what you are doing in the earth. We say thank you. We praise you. We honor you and exalt you. In the name of Jesus, receive all the glory. Receive all the praise. Receive all the honor. The God who sees in the circles of the earth, and you do that which pleases you. You do that which honors you. You do that which satisfies you. Receive our praise tonight in the name of Jesus as we praise you for the love of our Father and the Pastor. We show them a chance to be happy with the word. In the name of Jesus, the angel of this hour, the Lord, peace of divinity that is used to declare your intentions and to lead this family in your reformation agenda in the earth. We pray that in this new season, Spirit of God, you will cause our Father to increase more and more. In the name of Jesus, increase in wisdom, increase in intelligence, increase in creativity, increase in his desire and hunger for you. In the name of Jesus, increase in his sight, increase in his hearing, increase in his sensitivity, increase in his perception. In the name of Jesus, we give a praise for increase in his accuracy, increase in his diligence, increase in his discipline. In the name of Jesus, increase, Spirit of God, in walking in your truth, increase in submission. We thank you and we praise you, Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus, increase in influence, increase in affluence, Spirit of the living God, in the mighty name of Jesus, increase in good health, increase in peace of mind, increase in joy, increase in strength. We pray that you will increase in more and more. In the mighty name of Jesus, that our Father would only know victory. They would know, oh God, going up and becoming better and greater. In the name of Jesus, and we pray that Spirit of God, let everything that concerns him, his children, his family, his businesses, we pray that Spirit of God, that increase of the Lord will rest upon them. In the name of Jesus, increase in profit, increase in excellence, increase in achievement, increase in progress. We speak the increase of the Lord all around the Father. In the name of Jesus, increase in greatness, increase in honor. We thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we praise your holy name. That the increase of the Lord will be a portion of our Father, and it will be more and more by the day, by the week, by the month, in the year of many open doors. We thank you. In the name of Jesus, increase in the honor for you, Spirit of God. We praise your name. We honor you. We exalt you. In the name of Jesus, increase in broadcasting the glory and blessing of the love of the Father. We honor yourself for on this life. In the name of Jesus, in territories and in areas that have not been reached yet. In the name of Jesus, we praise you, Spirit of God, that you will glorify your name and continue to magnify your name. In the life of our Father, and we pray and we thank you in the name of Jesus that you will continue to walk as we led by your Spirit. We will continue to walk and be directed by your Spirit. That we continue to walk and be instructed by your Spirit. In the name of Jesus, we uphold your foundation agenda in this sanctity and in this spirit. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise. We honor you, we exalt you. In the mighty name of Jesus, for the increase you got our Father to walk in by the power of the Spirit.
It's a new season for us. And one of the things we've come to understand is that God is speaking to his people. And his people need to hear. Tonight we are praying to him that Spirit of the living God, open thou our eyes, that we'll be able to behold wondrous things out of your law. He is the God that gives the hearing ear and the seeing eye. We are calling on that God that gifts us with these blessings. The Spirit of the living God, remember the generation of leaders. Open our eyes to follow your path. Open our eyes that will not be part of those who are blind. We will not be part of those who don't hear. But we will hear you as you speak. And we will see your goings in the name of Jesus. Therefore, show us your glory. That in this new season, Spirit of God, we will not walk in ignorance.
but we would walk in the knowledge of God, that we will be sensitive and attentive. Tonight we are asking our Spirit of God, empower us to be sensitive and attentive to you in the name of Jesus. That ability to give you our full attention as we journey on with you in this new season, in the mighty name of Jesus. Can you lift up your voices as we continue to pray?
We bless you, Father.
Father, we give you praise in the name of Jesus.
We give you the praise and the glory.
We glorify you in the name of Jesus.
We magnify you
for this new season. This is the season you have made, and we know that you have gone on this road. You have completed this road. You have actually charted this road. You have orchestrated this road. You are the architect of this road. Therefore, we ask that you would show us your way. We ask that you would explore your way to us. We pray that you will lead us in your way.
We praise
in the mighty name of Jesus.
We are
strangers in this world. And we call on the God who made this world, that you will lead us by your Spirit.
In the name of Jesus.
Tonight we pray as a family that you will open our eyes. May it be a reservoir for us. In the name of Jesus. In this new season, that fire of the saints will be sensitive. That fire of the saints will be attentive. To your In the name of Jesus.
may the power of the Spirit, may we hear all the glory, may we receive you all the praise, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you that it is released. We thank you that it is released. We thank you that it is released. I will walk on the knowledge that I will enter into the heart of any man. We pray in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, you open us up, O God, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of Jesus, you open us up to hear, in the name of of us to have understanding of the times and to be able to interpret it accurately to our generation. It's a new season and we are calling on God, asking him that he will release upon this family the ability of his spirit to understand the times, the ability of his spirit to know what the church of God has to do, what the people of God ought to do, so that we'll be in alignment and God can fully express his glory in the earth, in the name of Jesus. First Chronicles chapter 12, verse number 32. And of the children of Issachar, which were men that had understanding of the times, to know what Israel ought to do. They have understanding of the times, and as a result of that, they operated as a generation of leaders. We are praying tonight, asking the Spirit of God, that understanding of the times and the knowledge of what to do will be the resemblance factor of the Fire City family, of the generation of leaders.
Amen.
And that we will not be confused, we will not be ignorant, we will not walk on in darkness, and that we will walk on in the understandings of God, that whatever season he ushers us in, whatever thing he opens up in the earth, the generation of leaders, the Fire City family, we would have understanding and we would know what to do in the mighty name of Jesus. The spirit of revelation, the spirit of understanding, and the spirit of knowledge, we are asking that the Spirit of God would make it be part of this family, a resemblance factor of this family, in the mighty name of Jesus. Come and lift up our voices and continue to pray.
We bless your name.
Just like God, we continue to give you praise.
In the name of Jesus, oh God.
We continue to exalt your name. We continue to magnify your name.
We
continue to praise you for this new season. And for what you have done for this family, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the generation of leaders. We thank you for your faithful family. And we thank you for your expectation of this family. In the name of Jesus, tonight we desire nothing as for that in this new season. The ability of the Spirit to work in understanding, to work in knowledge, the knowledge of God's understanding that comes from God to be released upon this family. We are desiring mercies of you tonight, that the Spirit of understanding of the times and the season will be a resemblance factor of the Fire City family. No matter the time, no matter the season, we will not lack understanding in the name of Jesus. We will operate and function as a resurrected leader in the name of Jesus. Let the knowledge of God continue to increase in this family. In the name of Jesus, as you speak to us, that we would notice it, we would recognize it, and we would walk in it in the name of Jesus. The Spirit of the living God, we call on you to show us your glory. We call on you to show us your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, release us upon us as we go on in this new season. As we go on in this new season, in the name of Jesus, so that we'll be the expression
the ability to know what to do.
The manifestation of your glory.
Let that happen in the name of Jesus.
That will do it as she wanted.
In the name of Jesus.
That will do it according to your healing in the name of Jesus.
Rest upon our lives, O God.
In the name of Jesus.
Almighty God.
Be exalted in the name of Jesus.
Bless us, O God, with that ability to understand and to know what to do.
In the mighty name of
Jesus. We give you the praise, O God. And we give you the glory.
Family, tonight we are again desiring mercies from the Spirit of God. And we have asked him for the eyes to see. We have asked him for understanding of the times and the knowledge of what to do. Tonight we want to continue to ask him that it is a new season. We want the capacity to be able to obey. As he shows us, we know that he has expectations of us. We are resurrected believers. We want to do right. So we are praying and asking him for the capacity to be able to obey when he speaks in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Psalm chapter 40, the verse number 6, the sacrifice and offering you do not desire, nor have you delight in them, but you have given me the capacity to hear and obey your law, a more valuable service than burnt offerings and sin offerings, which you do not require. Tonight, we are asking the Spirit of God, who gives the capacity to hear and the capacity to obey. Now we are asking that give us the capacity to obey, because we know that every word God gives, it comes with a power for fulfillment. There is that ability in it for it to be fulfilled, and there is that ability that it comes with to empower us to fulfill it. Tonight we are asking that in this new season, it should help us so that we would do well, that as we hear, we would obey. And we'll do it just as he wants it, so that we'll get the results just as he has designed them, in the mighty name of Jesus. Can we lift up our voices and continue to pray?
Thank you.
Father, we give you praise.
One
more time for this new season. We thank you for this blessed family. And we thank you for the generation of leaders. We thank the God who gives the capacity to hear when he speaks. In the name of Jesus, blessing the fasting family with the capacity to hear when he speaks, with the capacity to see when he moves, with the capacity to perceive that which the Lord minds and hearts cannot conceive. In the name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you. And we are asking for the capacity to obey your word. In the name of Jesus, that as you instruct the capacity to obey, in the name of Jesus, the capacity to hold on, the capacity to follow through the process, in the name of Jesus, the capacity to delight in your word and hold on to it until it's fulfillment. In the name of Jesus, the ability of the Spirit to be patient enough. To go through the process that you have said, in the name of Jesus, and the things you require of us to do, so we will be consistent, we will be able to continue by the power of your Spirit, that will not go after what we want, but will go after what you require of us, in the name of Jesus, and we will not hear you and not our way, but will hear and obey, in the name of Jesus, according to your perfect will. We want to do well in this new season, therefore we desire mercies from the Spirit, empowerment from the Spirit, in the name of Jesus, enablement from your Spirit, to be able to obey in the name of Jesus, as you instruct us to walk through the many open doors, carrying divine favor, that your will be done in the earth as it is in heaven, as you establish your kingdom in the earth, in the mighty name of Jesus. Take all the glory and the praise, Spirit of God. We honor you and we exalt you.
Almighty God,
in the mighty name of Jesus,
capacity, O God,
we thank God,
in the name of Jesus,
and we praise you,
we give you the praise and the glory,
in the name of Jesus.
Family,
we're going to pray for the church of God, and we are using the Fire City family as our point of contact, our very focus, and we're asking that as we pray for this family, God will reach out to the body of Christ in the earth, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of John chapter 1, the verse number 4 and the verse number 5. The Bible says that in him was life, and the life was the light of man. Verse 5, which is our emphasis. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. We are praying tonight in the name of Jesus that the Spirit of God will cause an awakening in his church. He will shine light in his church, that the church will begin to exhibit light, that darkness will not be able to resist anymore. The level of intelligence he will release upon the church, the level of wealth he will release upon the church. It has happened before. Ancient anointing. This is an ancient anointing that has worked on the earth before. And we are praying that as God has opened the doors, he shall remember his church. Light that darkness cannot comprehend. Intelligence, wealth, creativity, insight, influence, affluence that darkness cannot comprehend. He should release it. He should open that door upon the Fire City family, upon the church of God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that there will be an overturn in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's lift up our voices and continue to pray.
In the mighty name of God,
our Father, we give you praise and thanks. You alone are God, mighty warrior, great and battle. Jehovah is your name. You are the Father of all land. We honor you, Spirit of God, and we praise your holy name. We thank you for the anointing and the empowerment that was upon the life of Jesus, that the light that he exhibited, through the light that he led. The Bible says that darkness will not comprehend. We pray for an awakening in the church of God, the body of Christ. And we pray, just in your faith and family, as a point of contact, that birthing of kingdom lifestyle, that birthing of new energies in us, that will begin to live lives that will project the light of God that darkness cannot comprehend. In the name of Jesus, that your people will begin to live lifestyles that the world cannot understand. That the world cannot resist in the name of Jesus. Empowerment shall make the church not to play second fiddle in the name of Jesus. With empowerment, I will change the narrative of servants riding on horses and princes walking on the ground. We pray in the name of Jesus. Let the light of God be buried in the lives of the people. Let the light of God that is resonating in the lives of the people be to show forth. Open doors in the name of Jesus. Let the doors be open to exhibit fountain of life, kingdom life that would allow for your glory to be revealed in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the ability to live quality kingdom life that will provoke the heaven to respond to the earth in ways that has not been before, that your name will be glorified in the name of Jesus, that you will cause a turnaround in the air by the power of the Spirit. Thank you for the strength of wisdom, your blessed this family way, the strength of creativity, your blessed this family way, in the name of Jesus, to show forth the ability of God, to show forth the power of God, to show forth the wisdom of God, to show forth the creativity of God, to show forth the excellence of divinity, in the name of Jesus. To the living God, show us your glory, show us the temple of your glory, show the church of God in the earth your glory, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for the overturn, we thank you for the overturn, we thank you for the overturn, in the name of Jesus. We bless your name, we praise your name, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for the overturn, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. That you cross your hands one more time, and you reverse the darkness, O God, spirit of the living God, for the past year, in the name of Jesus, that the earth will be in alignment, the divine path of people, God. We show your glory one more time. We praise you, Jesus. We exalt you, God, in the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
We praise your God, and we honor you, O God.
We give you glory, O God,
and we praise your name.
And we give you the honor.
We give you glory,
in the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Finally, we want to pray. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs, chapter 22. I want to read verse number 28. Proverbs chapter 20. Or Job chapter 22. Job chapter 22, verse number 28. The Bible says that thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy ways. Family, it is a season of open doors.
and want to take an opportunity to speak open doors over the Fire City family. It's a new season for us. We know that we'll become greater and greater, we'll be better and better, we'll be stronger and stronger, we'll be wiser and wiser. Family, it's time for us to decree the blessings of the Lord over this family, over families in this family, over businesses in this family as we walk in it. The Bible says that for by faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God. We want to declare the words of blessings over this family in this new season. As we create and frame these worlds, that is what we are going to walk in the mighty name of Jesus. Can you lift up your voices as we pray finally tonight?
Spirit of the
thank
living
you,
Spirit
of God, for the season of open doors.
And we praise your name,
and we magnify your name
for our season of many open doors. We praise your name for this family. Thank you for opening us to the supernatural. Thank you for opening us to supernatural encounters and experiences. Thank you for opening doors to accurate insight and knowledge of you. Open us to the next level of wisdom, next level of wealth. Open us to next level of our health. Open us to next level of promotion. We thank you for opening us to the next level of achievement. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for opening us to the next level of knowledge and opportunity. For your greatness in the name of Jesus, open us to the next level of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, open us to the next level of protection, dignity.
We give you the praise in the mighty name of Jesus.
Family, the God we serve is a God that answers prayer, and that is why we come to Him to lift prayer to Him. He is the God who answers prayer. We believe that every prayer we have lifted before Him from morning till now, He has said and He has answered. And that is why we want to praise His name wherever you are. Thank Him for hearing us. Thank Him for doing it speedily. He says He will do a quick work. We believe it, so we praise Him. Let's thank Him for answered prayer and for the one that He is even, we did not ask that He will do for us. In the mighty name of Jesus, lift up your voices and bless His holy name.
We thank you, Spirit.
Father, we say thank you.
We give you the praise.
In the name of Jesus.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
We exalt your holy name in the name of Jesus.
We thank you, Lord.
We worship you for answered prayer in the name of Jesus. We adore you in the mighty name of Jesus. For this time in your presence, thank you for today. Thank you for every prayer that has been lifted from this altar, O Jesus. Thank you for hearing us. You are the God who answers prayer. He said, when we call on you, you will answer. And when you answer, you show as great and mighty things. We believe it and we receive it. And we praise you for it in the name of Jesus. For the change in this one, for the increase, for the many open doors, for the turnaround, all for your glory and your praise in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallowed be thy name now and forevermore. In the name of Jesus. Great I Am, we bless and praise you. We thank you because we know that you are the God who answers prayer. Thank you for hearing beyond that which mouth can speak. We thank you for hearing beyond what hearts can say. We thank you for doing beyond what our imaginations can conceive. Receive all our praise in the name of Jesus. For hearing us tonight and doing only what you can do for your glory. In this new season, we pray that you will lead us on by your Spirit and you help us be right with you every step of the way in the mighty name of Jesus. We praise you. We love you. We thank you. We adore you. We exalt you all the days of our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Spirit of God, for answered prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus. Can the resurrected believer shout, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And can we put our hands together to our God who is a prayer answering God? And we are doing it because we know that He's releasing the answer speedily. He is a sure God. And He will do it according to His perfect will. Can you say praise the Lord? Family, can please take a seat in His glory. We are going to give our offerings tonight. The Bible says in the book of Job chapter 22, the verse number 27. He said that thou shalt make thy prayer unto Him. That is the Most High God. And He shall hear thee. And thou shalt pay your vows. So that when you pray and He hears, the next step you take is that you give to Him. We have lifted prayer to the Most High God. Because we believe that He has answered. We are given to Him. I'd like you to prepare an offering to give to God as for answering our prayer. We have desired things for Him that when they happen, it will change this family forever. And we are expressing our gratitude to Him with our offerings tonight. If you're on ground, you can use the offering pouches to prepare your offerings. You can equally use the mobile money avenues to give your offerings. The giving platforms are displayed on our screen. Our international audience, you can please visit our website, wordfiregenerationministries.org. We have a button labeled Give. Kindly click on it, follow the prompts, and you'll be guided to give your offerings.
Kebale wonye meke sonlo ni ke wonja igana manse was mo nestra website ni ji wordfiregenerationministries.org. Hepa ko yana ngma ke obanyo ha e ahambo gbetwo mo ejo was mo ne obom mudin no hie na ka gbetwo mo ana bone afi no nyo sapole e nyomo ajobu ake wa fi no.
It's our new season. Please, if your offering is ready, kindly lift them up as we pray.
Eji be he ka ji was awa pole penya wo ana wo solia.
Father, we thank you for a new season. A season of access to all that you are and all that you have. We believe that we are empowered by your Spirit to access these, to be living testimonies and living proofs of your goodness. Thank you for the empowerment to walk through the many open doors you have set for this family in the mighty name of Jesus. We give to say that we are grateful to you. Be God in our lives now and forevermore. In Jesus' name have we prayed with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is my strength and my shield. Hallelujah. My heart trusts in the Lord and He helps me. Hallelujah. Strength like no one.
Indeed, the Spirit of God is our strength. Indeed, the Spirit of God is our hope. Indeed, the Spirit of God is our everything. Indeed, the Spirit of God is our everything. And we are grateful to Him for always and always and always coming through for the Word Fire family. Spirit of God, thank you so much for the privilege to be in your presence this evening. Thank you, thank you, thank you for being our strength. Thank you for being there and for carrying all of us. This is your doing, Spirit of God, and it's marvelous in our sight. This evening, the Word Fire family, we say, take all your glory, take all your honor, in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. It is an opportunity to be in the presence of the Lord. It is a privilege to be in the presence of the Lord. And today we are here to say thank you, Spirit of the Living God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Family, I'd like to take this time to acknowledge our Father, the lead pastor of our state chapel, Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman. Papa, thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much for loving this family. Thank you for always and always and always praying for us. May the Spirit of God be everything to you.
Amen.
May the Spirit of God answer you anytime you call on Him. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Family, join me again.
As I thank our Father
for the Destiny Boot Camp Reloaded.
Destiny Boot Camp.
I mean, it was incredible. But thank you so much. Thank you so much.
What a wonderful thing.
For showing us the way. God bless
you.
Family, please may have your seat. Family and guests, thank you all so much for coming for today's Destiny service. I know you have been blessed. On behalf of our Father, the lead pastor of our state chapel, Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman, I want to acknowledge all our guests, especially those fellowship with us for the first time.
Means my mother was chair na jani jo sofun ba Charles Kofi Hackman na jani ming pe me feni ka ba ja menek titri mening meneji na ken klem bi woke won danye shin akenya ko ba ja gbe
kene. God bless you.
Nyongbo ajo nye fe. Amen.
Amen. Family and guests, please be reminded that our school of worship and prayer will come off on Friday at 6:30 p.m.
We go akai wa ke so ani ba ni gbe ken meji ekpa ke fa oda solomon ke jamo bi baba no shikombe ko.
Man of God, treasure of wisdom, God bless you so much for leading us to pray today. Family and guests, please, the Women's Ministry is inviting all of us to an anniversary celebration tomorrow and Thursday at 7 p.m.
First, we go. Okay, we have a woman. Women's ministry needs to work. We are going to have a meeting.
The resource person is our own Father, the lead pastor of our state chapel, Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman. Our Father will be speaking to us on the empowerment of the woman being a vessel. We are all invited, so let us all come in our numbers. Thank you all for your attention. Please, we've come to the end of today's service. But please, before you go out of glory, kindly go to as many people as you can, high five them, give them a fist bump, and say to them, the Lord bless you and open many doors for you.
Amen. Amen.
the house of the Lord. This is the house of the Lord. This is the headquarters of heaven. This is glory. And we are grateful to the Spirit of God for permitting us to come into the headquarters one more time to have an encounter with Him. And on behalf of our Father and Lead Pastor, Bishop Dr. Charles Kofi Hackman, we'd like to thank all of you family and distinguished guests for making it for today's Destiny service. We believe that you have really been blessed by tonight's service, because there's something I always say, that you can't come into the headquarters of heaven and leave without a blessing, or leave the same way you came in. And so our belief is that anytime we walk into the headquarters of heaven, something changes about us. The Spirit of God speaks over us. He blesses us such that we are changed in the name of Jesus. So we believe that you have been blessed by today's service. Today, the man of God led us to discern mercies from above, to speak to the Lord our God, to pray to the Lord our God, because we've been blessed to be fasting yesterday and today, fastings. And so he led us into prayer today. But we pray that it will not just be it will not be the case that we only came to pray here and then afterwards we'll go and sleep or not pray again. You have to remember that this is the year that the Spirit of God is demanding of us to have a prayer pattern. So we pray that you will be empowered so that you will continue praying wherever you are, because the Lord your God is eager to hear your prayers and answer them speedily, so that all the blessings that He has in store for you, He would release it upon your life. And man of God, one of the things that we prayed about today has to do with the eyes to see and the ears to hear. And this bothers on the issue of sensitivity. Exactly. And we pray that the Spirit of God will open our ears. He should exchange our normal ears, our ordinary ears, for that kind of ears that hears only the Spirit. So that as the Spirit of God is speaking, we will hear Him. And when He's revealing Himself to us or revealing things to us, our eyes will see Him and what He is doing, so that we'll be able to walk in step with God. In this season, if you are not hearing God, if you are not seeing God, you are in big trouble, because the Spirit of God, he's revealing Himself, He's speaking to His people. So we pray that you will be part of those people that will hear the Spirit of God for your days.
In
you
will
hear the
of
Spirit
Jesus.
Of God concerning the steps you are supposed to take. You hear the Spirit of God concerning the decisions you are supposed to make, so that you will not take any wrong step. You would hear the Spirit of God concerning your family, your
Amen.
Children,
Amen.
Your businesses, your education, Amen. Everything that mattered to you. You would hear the Spirit of God concerning Amen. It, so that you'll be able to walk according to the perfect will of God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Man of God, how was the service for you today?
Incredible, incredible. For me, that, you know, we like prayer.
Yeah.
We like prayer, yes, we like the word, prayer. We like to worship, yes. We like intelligence.
Yes.
We like the blessings of God.
Yes, exactly.
So the service has been incredible. The privilege to be fasting for the past 2 days is just incredible. And one of the things the Bishop said from the Destiny Bootcamp is that the Destiny Bootcamp, we have ended it, but it shouldn't end there. We are actually beginning it, because we have been given a lot by the Spirit of God to be doing the new lifestyles.
Yeah.
And that is what we need to appropriate every blessing that the Spirit of God spoke to us through the Destiny Bootcamp. Man of God, the latter part of the service blessed me so much. The fact that in the fullness of your grace, in the power of your name, you lift me up. And I believe that fire citizens all over the world, our associates, we are being lifted up by the power of God, by the grace of God. So family, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it's important we continue in prayer, we continue in the word. The Bishop told us a couple of things to do. The fact that we need to pray, we need to be giving, and we must do something, especially towards progressing the house of God. You are reminded, Destiny Bootcamp has come to an end. We are now beginning to live the life. We shouldn't forget it. And we pray that the strength of God will be your portion, that every day of your life, you will adhere to instructions you have been given, that your eyes will be open to see the goings of God, your ears will be open to hear God speak to you concerning every aspect of your life, concerning your children and your generation. We have a responsibility to raise a generation. So we are supposed to be sitting as set men, set women, that the bishop is overseeing this family and this generation. We have a child to keep and a God to glorify. And we pray that the strength of God and the blessings of God will abound towards us and will rise up to responsibility and indeed change the narrative that in our generation, the children of the world will not be wiser than the children of light. You are blessed, you are strengthened, and you are empowered. In Jesus' name, can you say open doors?
Open doors. Right. And so we are reminding you once again that the Women's Anniversary continues tomorrow and Thursday. And we are grateful to the Spirit of God that we will be having our Father to be the speaker for the day. So please make time and join us. And your life will never be the same. And on Friday, we'll be having our School of Worship and Prayer. And Sunday at 8:30 a.m., we will be having our Covenant Service. So until we meet again, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon
Amen.
You and be gracious unto
Amen.
You. May the Spirit of the Living God lift up His countenance
yes,
upon
Lord.
You
we
and give you peace.
We receive
Continue
it.
Going through
we
this week
it.
Full of many open
many
doors.
Open
Can
doors.
You say, show me your glory?
Show me your
Once
glory.
Once again, thank you so much for coming and God richly bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Lead me on, Holy Spirit. Fill my heart, comfort my soul, lead me on into your presence, touch me. Thank you.